A landmark deal has been reached at the final hour of the COP26 climate summit in Glasgow. It set a new framework for the world to follow in an effort to curb catastrophic global warming. More money will also be given to help developing countries adapt to climate change. Corison Miller has more.
Hearing no objections, it is so decided.
The moment delegates from almost 200 nations struck a deal to try and curb global warming.
History has been made here in Glasgow.
You know, Paris built the arena, and Glasgow starts the race. And tonight, the starting gun was fired.
It came after all-night talks, three draft agreements, and a final desperate appeal for cooperation.
And this is the moment of truth for our planet. And it's a moment of truth for our children and our grandchildren.
The flurry of last-minute negotiations ending with a consensus for immediate action. A pact agreed on too, but only after a commitment to phase out coal included in earlier proposals was changed to phase down at the urging of India.
How can anyone expect that developing countries can make promises about phasing out coal and fossil fuel subsidies? Developing countries have still to deal with their development agendas and poverty eradication.
Others conceding it was this deal or no deal.
We do so only, and I really want to stress, only, because there are critical elements of this package that people in my country need as a lifeline for their future.
The concession casting a shadow over the summit and its goal of stopping the Earth from heating more than 1.5 degrees.
This is a fragile win. The pulse of 1.5 is weak.
The world needs to cut the rate of greenhouse gas emissions by almost 27 billion tonnes a year in order to limit global warming to 1.5 degrees by 2030. The current pledges, including those made at Glasgow, will only get us a quarter of the way there.
While civil society and science will be frustrated that we're not closer to 1.5, I think the nuanced success of this agreement is that at the very best, if all the country's new pledges add up, we could be at about 1.8 degrees.
I think Glasgow has provided a platform for ambition. And the challenge now is for countries to actually deliver.
To deliver on the promises made in Glasgow for the sake of future generations. Corazon Miller, One News.